I wanted to do a solo record. For one, I've always been in bands. I had a band called Lifter Puller that did four or five records. The Holt Steady's done five records, and it was like this summer I turned 40. I thought, oh, maybe it's time to do something just by myself, see what it would be like. But it was really good timing. The Holt Steady decided to take 4 or 5 months off last year, and I was like, I wanted to keep busy. So I thought, I was writing these songs that didn't seem to have a place with the Holt Steady. They're a little simpler, maybe a little quieter. I thought, maybe the time's right to do this. So I started to put the feelers out, talked to Mike McCarthy, the producer, and he was like, yeah, come on down, let's do this. I got some ideas. So that's how it started, and it ended up being a lot of fun and kind of allowed me to flex a different muscle than I get to in the Holt Steady, which is kind of more loud and celebratory. This is maybe more reflective and kind of, pulls creatively at a different part of my person. My favorite solo record, lately it's been Transformer by Lou Reed. The first Lou Reed, also the self-titled one, which people don't love a lot, but I really like that record. When I was making this record, I was listening to that a lot because I already knew the songs from the Velvet Underground. When Lou Reed got his first solo record, he had some of the same songs, but treated them very differently. And it kind of informed me as to like where a song starts and ends versus production and instrumentation. So it's kind of almost, listening to those records is kind of almost like a useful exercise. I really like, on the paper, Ron Wood's Hey, I Get to Make a Record Too. Looks like when you pick up the cover, it's not going to be good, but it turns out to be brilliant. So I will admit that there are sometimes solo records that make me feel dubious, but I can't come across one that I think is awful. There's a song called I Can Feel the Fire off that record, which is one of my favorite things ever. That's a different era of the music industry, but it literally like feels like they went to the label and got a whole bunch of money so they could have an awesome party in Jamaica. And somehow he brought Mick and Keith. It's like, well, what? This is some solo record you got. Just seemed like an excuse to open some wine. But it's a lot of fun, the whole record. Clear Heart Flies, it's funny, like when I announced that that's the song, and it's sort of a Friday Night Lights, all those juxtaposed, I deliberately said it wrong. It was a show I really loved. I was kind of annoyed when I first started reading things that said it was my whole album was about Friday Night Lights, and there's no songs about Friday Night Lights. It starts and stops with the title. However, I do like songs a lot about kind of going away and coming back, especially in a smaller town, going away is such a big deal. And so I think those moments in Friday Night Lights were concerned about leaving or coming back, and especially the whole storyline where Matt Sorensen had an opportunity to go to art school in Chicago. And as much as I rooted for the Dillon Panthers and the East Dillon Lions, I was rooting for Sorensen to get to Chicago and go to art school. That almost killed me. So I think that those are the really nice moments of that show.